Korn fan actually since 94. I bought the album about, maybe not when it came out, but probably like a week before it came out, because I've been hearing about them in like fanzines and kind of in the underground, you know, for a while, you know, since they were playing shows in 93 and stuff, because I had a lot of friends that were out in L.A. telling me about this band Korn that was coming out, and I definitely need to check it out. So, you know, I looked for it until I could find it, and I've been a fan ever since. You know, they started like a whole movement, and I don't care what anyone says, you got to give it to them. They are the forefathers of what, you know, became like a certain music style that, you know, a lot of bands, you know, came out and, you know, copied and tried to emulate. They're the originators of it. The fact that I got to actually sit in and play with them is an ultimate honor, and that's the reason why I really did it, is because they really were a huge influence for me. You know, huge. That was kind of an idea that I kind of stole from Fieldy when I saw his bass, because I just thought it was cool. And I was, you know, obviously designing a way bigger drum kit for Family Values because of, like, the new songs with, you know, Bozio's style and everything. But, you know, so I wanted a, you know, with all the lights, I wanted a white kit that would actually shine out with the chrome and, like, the chrome octobons and the chrome gong drum. So pretty much, you know, it's shaped, you know, for pretty much my style that I play in Slipknot, with a bunch of, like, extras. It's a killer-looking kit. It's the coolest-looking kit that I've ever played on, so. It was pretty much, you know, that was pretty much the idea. Thanks, Fieldy. I was already injecting my style as it is, but Fieldy, we call it the Fieldy remix. Every time we'd play, like, a Korn classic exactly the way it was, he'd be like, man, I'm bored, let's do this. And he would just start changing stuff, like, falling away from me in the middle. But then I just added all those crazy fills in, because it just seemed to fit. End of Blind is pretty much kind of like they let me kind of go off and show like my actual style that people pretty much know me for, and it's the end of, you know, the show, and it just gets really intense, you know. But you know, it's cool. People been digging it. People were skeptical at first, but they've came around, and it's been a great experience. You know, like I said, it's been fun. I'm glad that they let me interject my style. Shut up. Some of my favorite shows I've ever done in my career. Download was absolutely insane, like having to stop like three times. People almost tore the tent down, you know, and, you know, John had to stop. It's like, if you want us to keep playing, you know, you guys got to get down. People scaling the rafters. The crowd was just absolutely insane.
What's up, everybody?
Also, Rock'em Ring, Rock'em Park were like 90,000 people. The end of Somebody, Someone with the fists. It was just like a wave, and it just sent chills up everyone's spine. It was just amazing.
All right, come on, everybody.